over 7,000 miles now on our GT5. I'm thinking it's time to, you know, kind of pull the disc out of the console and wrap up our thoughts on this game. Obviously, you can't put over 7,000 racing miles on something and say it's not addictive or it's not fun, because that would be really untrue. We find it a joy. As we said in our initial, you know, take on this, it's a really deep program. Lots of cars, lots of tracks, and then different levels that you work your way up through. And we've actually gotten to the point now to where we're at the endurance level, where all the races are, 60 laps, 4 hours, 500 miles, 300 kilometers, 1,000 kilometers, 24 hours. So they've become really long. And I do like real race lengths instead of the 3-lap races. That's one of my beefs, is in 3 laps, it's really hard to get into a rhythm. I mean, you need to get into a rhythm fast, but I prefer longer. You know, keep that concentration going for a while. And that's one of the things that I like about this, is the different levels. But also, it's one of the things I wished it was a little bit different, in the fact that perhaps the levels, you progress through the levels not by earning money and working your way up, but you progress based on your performance, like a real race team would be, to where, you know, you did well and then you moved up to a better car, faster car, better series, and then worked your way up that way. It's nice to have all the cars, nice to have all the tracks. I do wish there was more local tracks. For those of us in the U.S., I wish there was more local tracks where you'd race, you know, the real cars, Elkhart Lake, Road America, Watkins Glen, Virginia Raceway, Infineon, the old Riverside Raceway, tracks like that that we could race on, would make it more enjoyable for me. And as far as the cars, I wish the tuning of the cars was more realistic as well. But with all that said, you know, maybe that's what places like R Factor are iRacing is for. So, and this is what it is. It thoroughly enjoyable, a lot of fun, obviously really addictive, and for this kind of money, I got my money's worth out of GT5 10 times over. It's amazing how much time I have spent on this and how addictive it's been. So, yeah, even though we're going to pull it out and move on to something else for the review, I'm going to come back to this because I really enjoy it. And my beefs against, maybe a little bit lack of realism and lack of realistic tracks and lack of realism for the setup, that can be answered by other race sources like iRacing. We'll find out. That's all I can say is we'll find out. And when we do, you'll be the second to know.